I think a lot of people, including the recent investors, are penciling out the growth they've had in China as if it will go across the world with similar ease. Will it?
I think in emerging markets there is a distinct possibility, largely because the price points of these phones are a lot lower than some of the higher-end smartphones. So I would say, you know, any of the emerging markets, Russia, India, you could see similar growth rates.
Why? What is it about those markets that, I mean, everyone likes a bargain?
Absolutely, but bargain at a much higher quality point as well. You're getting an Apple-like experience for almost, you know, I would say one-fourth the price. That's hard to beat. You know, I actually had this discussion with a friend of mine a few weeks ago when they were selling some Xiaomi equipment on Flipkart, which is the India's equivalent of Amazon, and I think all of it was sold within 6 seconds or 7 seconds. So if you were to look at that level of excitement, one of the other things Xiaomi does is they limit the supply of the whatever they're selling, either it's a phone or an iPad or a phablet. And, you know, that really makes it a, you know, big deal as well.
I wonder if they have copyright problems that will make it much more difficult to come into a market like the U.S., that the Apple-like experience might be owned by Apple and they'll get their pants sued off if they try to sell in the U.S.
Yeah, I think that's going to be a problem in any of the Western world.
So maybe they are limited to the places where that copyright protection doesn't extend?
I wouldn't say it doesn't extend, but the laws are not as strict as I would say as they are in the U.S. or in Europe. But at the same time, I mean, the growth market is this, you know, low-end smartphone markets. The growth market are the emerging markets. If you really want to think about it, you know, I would say how many people in the U.S., you know, need to buy another smartphone that they already don't have one?
So among the investors in the most recent round was the very optimistic Yuri Milner of DST, a Russian investor in a lot of big technology companies, not least of which Facebook. Of course, he was also there in size in Groupon. And listen to what he had to say in terms of talking about that investment and how he chose it. He said, "I was attracted by the size of the opportunity ahead of them. I don't think there's a company that's reached $1 billion in revenue as fast as Xiaomi. In every conceivable benchmark, it's unprecedented in terms of its speed of growth. But I would add that it's probably unprofitable growth, and that the company has made a point of saying, we're going to offer a top experience because our profits are so small. Does that put the future of the company in a little more risk than it might be otherwise?
See, one of the things all you know, technology companies have been embarking on over the last several years to make sure they have the biggest mind share possible. Now, we don't know what they have in stock, but it's possible they might, you know, offer some digital services, some gaming, some kind of internet videos on the platform once they have a huge customer base.
So in other words, establish the phone as a delivery device, not a profit center, so that you can profit from the goods and services that come across the phone.
I would say so.
So should we therefore be looking for other investments from Xiaomi that aren't phone related but are content related?
Yes, we have heard rumblings that they have tied up with Baidu. They have another internet TV provider in China that they have a deal with. It's possible they might look into gaming. You know, all sorts of stuff that can be delivered through this particular platform once you have a sizable user base.
The carriers who are offering that content might have something else to say about that as well.